Hi there. Are you looking for a lovely and engaging game that can be used to check or reinforce students' knowledge? If so, the following game called Way Back Home is right for you. On the way back home, the character will encounter many obstacles. To overcome, he has to answer all the questions correctly. In case there is any wrong answer, the game will navigate to the game over slide. Click the replay button to restart the game. After submitting all correct answers, the game will move to the congratulations slide. Now, let's explore how to create the game through three big questions in turn. How about the preparation stage? What is the game's layout? And how to create Way Back Home? Firstly, import all the resources used in the game to the resources pane as follows. By this way, you can select objects directly from the pane, without looking for them from your folder many times. Next, customize the slide layouts in the Slide Master. You can set background images and other properties for the slide layouts. Press Ctrl A to select all the layouts and disable the Auto Advance feature to prevent the slide from jumping to the next slide automatically without player's interactivity. Besides, accessing the Transitions tab to add more smooth transitions between slides. Close the Master View to save the changes. Later, insert slides to your project and name them. I will select 10 slides from the new slide of the Home tab. As can be seen, they are customized in the Slide Master before. Double-click any slide name to rename it. Way Back Home is built up from 10 slides containing Welcome, Content, Questions, Game Over, and Congratulations. Now, we'll learn how to create each slide to complete the game. As shown in the previous part, the game contains 6 question slides. To make questions appear in unpredictable order, each time playing the game, we need to create a question pool and random slides. Click the question icon to add the corresponding question type. Once completing questions, access the View tab, select Slide Pools. Then, the Slide Pools pane comes up on the right side of the canvas. Now, select 6 question slides in the Slides pane, right-click them, move slide to Pool 1. After that, 6 question slides were moved to the Pool 1, and you no longer see them on the Slides pane. By default, the value of the points and attempts sections of each question is 1. This means players have only one chance to submit the answer, and they will get 1 point for each correct answer. However, the game will navigate to the game over slide once players give a wrong answer. Therefore, we add go to slide, game over, instead the default actions. Repeat the performance for other questions. Finally, insert 6 random slides after the content slide. These random slides are linked to pool 1. As a result, we have 10 slides, with 6 random slides replacing 6 original question slides. The welcome slide includes the game's name, description, and the play button. To get it done, take the following steps. Enter the description to the game. Next, insert a button. Now, access the object states pane to edit the button state. Click Edit States, and set up the background image for the normal and hover state. Then, adding events actions to the play button to navigate to the content slide, when clicking the button. It's time to learn creating the content slide. This is the main slide which shows all the obstacles and characters' motion paths. First of all, drag and drop all the desired images from the resources pane into the canvas and name them. Then, add the new state change direction for the character. Also, select all the obstacle images and change their cursor type. In Active Presenter, using multiple timelines will help to organize and control specific tasks. Now, perform the steps below. Click here, and select Add Timeline. Then, rename the newly added timeline to Way 1. So, you are in the Way 1 timeline. Follow my lead to create motion path for the character. In addition, adding effects to the obstacle to bring more curiosity to players. Place the playhead at the end of the previous effect, select Obstacle 1, and choose Teeter. Click here to see how everything works. Redo the above steps to create 5 additional timelines with effects, for character, and obstacles. The Way 1 timeline works right after the content slide appears. Hence, we set up action and conditions for the slide on load event like this. The variable AppQuest score is used to count the total score that players get. Next, when the character encounters obstacle 1 and clicks on it, the game navigates to a random question. So, we add on click event with go to slide action, select slide 3. Set up the condition, if AppQuest score is equal to 0. Then, add play audio action, select mouse click 1 from the built-in list. After getting 1 correct answer, players will get 1 point, and the corresponding obstacle disappears. We continue adding action and conditions to do that. Perform the above steps to set up events, actions, conditions for the slide, and obstacles. Using the hotkeys Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V is a great way to save your time and effort for this progress. Remember to customize them exactly. After crossing obstacle 2 and getting 2 points, the character will change direction and continue moving on the way 3. So, in the slide on load event, we set up the actions and conditions like this. Finally, set up action and conditions to go to the congratulations slide, if players answer all the questions correctly. Here is what you've created. If players give a wrong answer, the game will end and move to this slide. Players can replay the game if they click the replay button on the slide. We add restart presentation action to the button on click event. After that, drag and drop the game over audio into the canvas. The game navigates to this slide after players submit all correct answers. Besides the text notifying the victory, you can add audio to make players more excited. Now, we'll create a consistent look and feel for feedback layers in the game. Select the master layout and adjust its properties. The custom layouts inherit all the shifts from the master layout. Also, you can modify each custom layout as you wish. Set up events, actions to the continue button in the correct feedback layer, helps players to go back to the content slide, and continue the game. Close the feedback master view to save the changes you've made. Finally, you are free to preview your project, or export it to HTML5, SCORM, or XAPI packages, depending on your needs. It's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.